बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अनदर टॉपिक फ्रॉम द चैप्टर नंबर 5 वैरायटी ऑफ लाइफ एंड द रिमेनिंग टॉपिक इज वायरल डिजीजेस इन ह्यूमन बीइंग्स। सो वायरल डिजीजेस इन एनिमल्स, दिस इज द रिलेवेंट पोर्शन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 5 एंड वी हैव सो मेनी वायरल डिजीजेस। You can say that the viruses are widely spread all over the world, or there are so many types of viral diseases and so many types of viruses. So some of the diseases are included in your syllabus, just like polio, common pox, common cold, influenza, rabies, HIV, and mumps, measles, and hepatitis A, B, and C. So we will discuss these diseases in detail. So firstly, what is transmission or how the disease transmit? Viral diseases are contagious and spread from one person to another person. As you know that virus enter in the body and begin to multiply so many ways from one person to another person, and you can get that disease by breathing in airborne droplets, like you can say that it's contaminated with the water, or if you are eating food or drinking water which may be contaminated with that virus, you can be affected. And another way is indirect transmission. It means from person to person by the virus host, such as mosquitoes and ticks and other pets. So we will discuss viral diseases in human beings. The first one disease, as you know, that is polio, poliomyelitis, or this is caused by the polio virus. In 1908, two physicians in Vienna, Carl Sturen and Erwin Popper, was the first time who discovered that the polio virus affect the human beings. Polio is the common name for the virus, for the disease poliomyelitis, which comes from the Greek word which means for gray and marrow, referring to the spinal cord, and the suffix itis means inflammation. It means this disease affect your spinal cord, that's why the affected person's limb will be not affected, or that will function not function properly. So poliomyelitis shortened become, you can say that it's a polio for the time being. Polio was called as infantile paralysis, or through it did not affect only the youngs. The virus infects a person's spinal cord, as I have told you that it can cause the paralysis and the person will be unable to move its limb. Here you can see the picture of a boy who is limping because his limbs, or your lower limb, yeah, his legs not working. So what is the history of poliovirus? In the early 20th century, polio was one of the widest feared disease in industrialized areas or in industrialized countries, paralyzing hundreds and thousands of the students every year. Soon after the introduction of effective vaccine in 1950s or 1960s, polio became very much controlled because it was practically eliminated as public health emergency in these areas. In 1988, when the global polio eradication initiative begins, polio paralyzed more than 1,000 children worldwide every day. Since then, the global incidence of polio has declined by the 99%, and more than 2.5 billion children have been immunized by the polio vaccine. And now there are more than 200 countries and 20 million volunteers backed by the international invest. They invest more than 11 US dollars billions every year to eradicate that disease. So there are only now 3 countries which are never stop polio transmission, in which unfortunately Pakistan is also included, and Afghanistan and Nigeria, where randomly the cases of polio has been reported. So what are the characteristics of polioviruses? Polioviruses have affiliation to the nervous system, as I have told you that your spinal cord, PNS, peripheral nervous system will be affected, and the cells of interior horns of the spinal cord and cranial nerves, motor neurons affect, and polio replicates at 37 degrees centigrade. Poliovirus can easily be killed by heating or you can say ultraviolet rays you can use, and some chemicals such as formaldehyde and chlorine. It means when you sanitize your homes, your workplaces or your belongings or your nearabouts, then you will not get that virus. Polio can withstand acidic environment. It means it can withstand with a pH range of 3 to 5 pH. This is the reason that they can survive exposure to gastric acid. So here is the structure of poliovirus. It's a RNA virus and having glycoprotein and viral capsid. It's an enterovirus or belongs to the picornivirid family, and it's a single-stranded positive strands RNA virus and having protein coat, and it can colonize in gastrointestinal tract. It means your digestive tract. So polio is icosahedral. You can see that this is icosahedral and having 20 to 30 faces or edges, and it is surrounded by the polygon or poliovirus. Has no envelope. It is an RNA virus and its size is 30 nanometer. So there are so many types of polio, and mostly we consider that there are three types. The first one is abortive polio, and then non-paralytic polio and paralytic polio. Abortive polio, which means that it causes polio in mild illness with viral symptoms like fever, fatigue, headache, and abortive polio can be healed by using different medicine. While non-paralytic polio, it means it involves the symptoms of abortive polio and additional neurological symptoms such as sensitivity to light and neck stiffness. While paralytic polio occurs when the virus enters the central nervous system and it will replicate itself in motor neurons and the spinal cords. When it multiplies in the nervous system, the virus destroys your nerve cell, your motor neurons, because motor neurons send messages to the skeletal muscles to activate them, and due to the paralytic polio, the person will be affected, and mostly the children under the age of 3 will be affected with the polio. So how it transmit from one person to another person, or you can say that it passage of transfer. You know that polio cannot be transferred from one person to another person because it only can be transmitted through the intestinal source by the contact with the contaminated feces or oral to oral. It means oropharyngeal source route. Through contact between people by nasal and oral secretion, poliovirus entered the body through the mouth, multiply along with the digestive tract where it further multiplies. And here are some preventions and treatments. There are two types of vaccines which can prevent polio. The first one is inactive polio vaccine, which is given in the form of injections in the legs or arms depending on the patient age. Only inactive polioviruses have been used in the United States since 2000. The second one is oral poliovirus vaccine, which is still used in all over the world or even Pakistan. Here is another disease which is known as common cold and rhinovirus, the virus which causes a common cold. So you know that this is related to the nose. The common cold that infect the upper respiratory tract, this respiratory tract will be affected, and it is also known as acute viral rhinopharyngitis, or you can say that acute coryza. It is common condition infection disease in the human being, mainly caused by the different virus. Even the coronavirus also caused the common cold. There are more than 200 viruses which is are very much common and they cause cold condition. So the common cold is contagious. It can be transmitted from the air droplets, through cough and sneezing, or by touching the infected person. So flu virus can be occurs within 1 to 2 days before symptoms begin until the symptoms have stopped. So this is a structure of rhinovirus. You know that this is also a single-stranded RNA virus, and its incubation period is 1 to 3 days, or in 1 to 3 days you will get the temperature from 96 degree to the other notable degree, and it not stable below the pH of 5 to 6. So, common here are the symptoms of common cold. As you know that you will feel dry throat, sore throat, cough and mild fever, sneezing, horse wise blocked nose. Just like in the now winter season, we feel that there is a common cold, but there is a very much difference between the common cold and corona virus or COVID-19. So these are the symptoms of common cold in children as well. They will feel headache and then sneezing, coughing, and then pain in their body, and sometimes ear pain, and the temperature will exceed from 101 or 102. Okay, that kids will not feel appetite, and they will usually unusual drowsiness they will feel. So the preventions for cold is you have to wash your hands, you have to disinfect your stuffs and use tissues, don't share your belongings with the others, and then choose your child care center. If you are feeling that there is the cold symptoms are prevail, then you have to visit the doctors for proper medication. So another disease is rabies. Rabies, here you can see that rabies, the disease. What is rabies? Rabies is viral infection mainly spread through the bite of infected animals. We will commonly say that when infected dog will bite anyone else, then it will get the rabies. Rabies is also an RNA virus and belongs to the rhabdo family. Or without early treatment, it is very much fatal if the person is affected or the person bitten by the stray dog. He or she should consult immediately to the doctor. The virus can affect the body in two ways. The first one is that it will enter the peripheral nervous system and directly migrate to the brain. And the second one is that it replicates within the muscles tissues, where it will be safe from the host immune system. From here, it enters the nervous system through the neuromuscular junctions. So here are the some ways of transmission of rabies. Rabies is common in those countries in which the stray dogs are in large number, especially the countries belongs to the Asia or Africa, and this is passed through the infected saliva. It can transmit by the different types of mammals like dogs, raccoons, coyotes, bears, skunks and foxes and other animals. Any animal which can be harbored and transmit the virus, but smaller mammals such as rodents rarely become infected or transmit rabies. Rabies are unlikely to spread by the rabies. Symptoms, there are it progresses in five distinct stages. The first one stage is incubation. At incubation is the period when it will multiply itself. It usually lasts from 3 to 12 weeks, or it can start from the fifth day to it lasts from till 2 years. And then prodrome. Prodrome means early flu-like symptoms including fever, and then you will feel the headache, anxiety, and sore throat and cough, nausea and vomiting, and also discomfort. And the third one, which is the very severe period of that disease, is acute neurological period. It means the person will feel confusion, aggression, and then involuntary muscle twitching, and then its neck becomes stiff, and also hypersalivation will occur, and the person will affected with the hydrophobia. And hydrophobia is a combination of two words. Hydro means water and phobia means fear, because it will be difficulty in swallowing the water and other things. Then the person will feel the hallucination, and then insomnia. It means the person will unable to sleep properly, and then photophobia also is a cause of the rabies. And the last stage is mad frenzy. People will suffer with the mad frenzy, and then the coma. Most people suffer with a coma, and then ultimately death if they are not properly medicated. So here is the stages. You can see the first one stage, man bitten by the rabbit animal like dog, and then virus from infected dog or infected animal to the human body, and then it will multiply and ultimately affect your nervous system. And here are some animals like bats, dogs, wolf, and these are the principal animals which can cause rabies. So the treatment, as you know, that the treatment due to rabies is very much a fatal disease, and the vaccine was developed in 1885 by Louis Pasteur and Emily Rox. If the person is bitten or scratched, it means if you are not bitten, the animal tried to bite you and you got the scratches, then you may affected with the rabies. So you have to go to the doctor, and firstly you have to wash the scratch for 15 minutes with the soapy water, and then you can pyogene solution, and then sometime you have biodine is available at home or not. So after the exposure and before symptoms begins, you have to go to the doctor, and then you need medication, properly medication. So there are two strategies: a fast acting dose of rabies immunoglobulins or rabies vaccine may be administered, and the second one is a series of the rabies vaccine, or these will be injections, and you will get injection in next 2 to 4 weeks, and then you can survive. Otherwise, if you are not getting proper medication and treatment is too late, and then the person, it will be fatal and person may die. Another disease, which is AIDS. AIDS is a combination of 4 words, as you know that AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, and it was first recognized in North America in 1980s, and it is caused by the virus also known as HIV virus. It is a retrovirus, and HIV infection is a worldwide epidemic, and the World Health Organization estimate that it's from its discovery now approximately 36 million people are died worldwide with this disease, and in 2013 approximately 35.3 million people were living with AIDS in Canada, over 23,000. It's all over the world now. So this is the structure of retrovirus. Retrovirus also again RNA virus, and you can see the protein code, lipids, and it has reverse transcriptase properties. So retrovirus belongs to the family lentivirus, which is again structure. So the symptoms and complications of HIV. Symptoms or infections appear after 2 to 12 weeks after exposure. At this point, the virus begins rapidly and taking over your immune system. It means your defense mechanism will be affected, and it causes the first symptoms like diarrhea, weakness, fever, joint pain, rash, swollen glands, weight loss. What does HIV do to the immune system? The main thing is that HIV attack on your white blood cells or T cells, and then the T cells will, as you know, that these are the guards of your body, and then the T cell will decrease, and the person becomes susceptible to all types of disease, because when T cells are affected by the AIDS, then AIDS will develop. So how AIDS will spread, how HIV will spread? HIV will spread by sharing needles, syringes, and sharing tattoos equipments, and piercing, and other during pregnancy or during cesarean cases, or from other to the young ones, homosexuals and heterosexuals, are also transmitted through the blood secretions. HIV cannot be spread by using usual contact. This is just like if you are shaking hands, then you will not get the HIV. Or you can use, if you are using toilet seat, or if you are eating food prepared by the HIV person, a positive person, or it cannot be affected by the saliva or sweats. Now, what is AIDS? AIDS is a disease that can develop in people with HIV, or you can say that AIDS is an advanced stage of HIV. But just because person has HIV does not mean that he will get develop into AIDS. So what is AIDS? AIDS is a disease which develop in people with HIV patient, and it is the advanced stage of HIV, and the people will having a person having HIV will does not may develop into the AIDS. So untreated HIV can progress into the AIDS within a decade. There is no cure of AIDS, as you know that AIDS is incurable, and without treatment life expectancy after diagnosis is about 3 years or not more than 3 years. If it develops, it means that immune system is severely compromised, it is weakened, it is open, it is not defending, it is not fighting against the disease, and the person will open for all the disease. And the symptoms like pneumonia, tuberculosis, all type of disease like Kaposi sarcoma, it's a skin cancer, and then night sweat, and the person will have rapid weight loss, and then toxoplasmosis, or his brain will be affected and brain starts shrinking, and the person will have anxiety and depression. So what's the connection between HIV and AIDS? To develop AIDS, person has to have contracted HIV. But having HIV does not necessarily means that someone will develop AIDS. In case of HIV progress to 3 stages, the first one stage is acute stage, the first few weeks of transmission, and the second one is clinically chronic stage, and third stage is the AIDS. So there are few you can say that treatment or medication like zidovudine, azathioprine, ribavirin. There are so many organizations working on the vaccine or on the treatment of the AIDS, but here, still there is no proper therapy, or you can say that proper treatment. But you can control the virus, its progressive multiplication, by using different types of therapies or by using different types of medicines. Another disease which is in your syllabus is hepatitis, mostly we are confusion that there is only three types of hepatitis: hepatitis A, B, or C. So hepatitis not only three types, so many types like A, B, C, D, E, F, and G types also. But in your syllabus, you have only 3 types of hepatitis, and we will discuss only those 3 types, which is included in your syllabus. What is hepatitis? Yes, you know that hepatitis is inflammation of liver, in which your liver will be affected, and the person will affect, and it will symptom the it will appear. Yeah, you can observe the symptoms of jaundice, like yellowing of the skin and eyes, and then abdominal pain and loss of appetite and nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and ultimately fever. So here is hepatitis A. This is a virus of hepatitis A. You can see the figure of hepatitis A virus, including RNA virus. It is also RNA virus having capsid. Hepatitis A is contagious liver infection caused by the hepatitis A virus. Hepatitis A and E are acute and short-term viral infections transmitted through water or food contaminated by fecal matter. It means those person who are not who are exposing or who are using the contaminated water or food, and it will be primary source of hepatitis A. So you should wash your hands properly, you should clean the your belongings, and you should cook your food properly. It means uncooked or raw food also causes the hepatitis A. So these are the symptoms, and more or less similar symptoms in all type of hepatitis, like reduced hepatitis, jaundice. You can see that yellowing of eyes, fever, and you observe the dark pale urine, and then nausea and the pain in the right side of the abdomen. As you know that your liver lies on the right side of your body, abdomen, and stomach is on left side. So digestive disorders, diarrhea, and then weakness or joint pain. These are the common symptoms in all types of hepatitis. And the common food which are hepatitis A are shellfish. It means these are the raw food or contaminated drink. If you are using, then you have to properly sanitize or you have to properly wash these type of food, and you can use this. So vaccines. So hepatitis A vaccine offer excellent protection against hepatitis A virus. It is safe and effective. Vaccine consists of two doses, or you can say that shots. 6 to 12 months support and apart and protection start from 1 to 2 weeks after the first dose, and then the last for 20 years to the life after two doses. And for infants that will be traveling internationally, an early dose of hepatitis A can be given at the age of 6 to 11 months. It is another disease, hepatitis B. Hepatitis B is also a liver disease. It caused by the hepatitis B virus. You can see this is the structure of hepatitis B virus. But hepatitis B is a DNA virus, and most hepatitis B infection clear up to 1 to 2 months without treatment. When the infection lasts more than 6 months, it may be developed into the chronic hepatitis B, which can lead to chronic inflammation of the liver and cirrhosis, scarring of the liver or liver cancer, and you can say that liver failure. So hepatitis B complications, there are so many complications. The person affected with the hepatitis B, the first one is cirrhosis or scarring of the liver. This makes it's harder the liver to work, as you know that our liver perform more than hundreds of the functions of our body. So if liver is not right, then you are not also in right condition. And then it leads to the liver cancer, and then liver failure, and it also affect on your kidney, and also affect on your blood vessel problems, because in blood vessels you also feel inflammation. Here's again the symptoms. As I have told you, there are more or less similar symptoms in all type of hepatitis. And the mode of transmission, as I have told you, that if you are using non-sterilized tools of dental practices, or you are with contaminated drug needles or piercing, or contaminated vaccine equipment, or tattooing the needles, then you will extract that disease, or you will affect the boy that disease. Hepatitis B treatment, and hepatitis B, if a person is suffering with hepatitis B, so there are so many complications, and the patient with chronic hepatitis B is treated with medications to reduce the activity of the virus and prevent liver failure. And medication include interferon injections and lamivudine injections, or oral medication. Or chronic hepatitis B person should avoid that further can injure the liver, such as alcohol. They should not use alcohol and other sources which can cause the hepatitis B. So if the hepatitis B occurs, if you need liver transplantation. So here's hepatitis C, virus hepatitis C. So you can see the hepatitis C structure, and it's also common disease. The symptoms same, and also transmission same. So the treatment depend on the condition of the viruses or the stages. Okay, so here's the difference between different types of hepatitis A, B, and C. So thank you. Your health is your wealth.